I would kindly ask my audience that they should be very patient, be quiet, just follow the proceedings. Those with the phones, put them in silence. If you want to chat with your loved ones, chat with them in silence. Don't interfere. The press men, you stay one side. No crossing. Okay, proceed.
May it please the Lordship Chairman and honorable members of this court. My name is Peter Watson. I'm appearing with my learned colleagues, Dr. Eric Kamhanga, Dr. Kalu Karunia, Mr. Joseph Matsko, Dr. Edison Karohanga, Mr. Jet Nevase, and my Lord also appearing with us is Captain Charles Sekaita. As a defense team, Captain Charles Sekaita has been kindly provided on our team and the auspices of this honorable court. We all come from Kampala Society of Advocates, who are counsel to General Kale Kayihura. The prosecution team is led by our learned colleagues, Major Raphael Mugisha and Lieutenant Ambrose Bakuma. Your Lordship and members, we shall give these details to the registrar.
Okay, let's proceed. The Republic of Uganda. Okay.
My lord,
Mutami.
Please. I will tell you that before him is a part of the 40 members and the chairman. Before you, the panel of 40 members, the chairman, the reserve members, you put your hands up. You can look at all of them. You have any questions from the panel of the different directors?
The Republic of Uganda, Uganda for Defense Forces, the General Court Marshal, all in at Makindi. Criminal case number UPDF stroke GMC stroke 037 stroke 2018, dated 24th August 2018. Shot sheet Uganda versus RO 00513, General Edward Kale Kayura, a male adult of sound mind, age 62 years, a member of the Regional Forces of Uganda Police Defense Forces, formerly deployed as Inspector General of Police. The person subject to military law is charged with statement of offense, count one. Failure to protect war materials contrary to section 122, subsection 1, subsection 2, clause D of Uganda Police Defense Forces Act of 2005. Particulars of the offense. General Edward Kale Kayura, between the year 2010 and 2018, on various occasions, allowed the issue of arms and ammunition to unauthorized persons, to wit, members of Boda Boda 2010, headed by one Abdallah Kitata. General Edward Kale Kayura, have you heard and understood the statement and the particulars of the offense? Do you agree or deny the charge?
I deny the charge.
Plea of not guilty entered. Statement of offense. Count two. Failure to protect war materials contrary to section 122, subsection 1, subsection 2, clause I of Uganda Police Defense Forces Act 2005. Particulars of the offense. General Edward Kale Kayura, between the year 2010 and 2018, failed to supervise and ensure accountability for the arms and ammunition issued to units referred to as specialized under the office of the IGP, to wit, Flying Squad Unit, Specialized Operation Unit, the Witness Protection Unit, and the Crime Intelligence Directorate of Uganda Police Force. General Edward Kale Kayura, have you heard and understood the statement and the particulars of the offense?
I
Do you agree or deny the charge?
I deny
the charge. Plea of not guilty entered. Statement of offense. Count three. Aiding or abetting kidnapping from Uganda, contrary to section 19, subsection 1, plus C, and section 242 of the Penal Code Act, cap 120. Particulars of the offense. General Edward Kale Kaiwura, between the year 2012 and 2016, by omission and commission, aided and abetted the actions of subordinate police officers and others on various occasions without hindrance to kidnap and illegally repatriate Rwandan exiles, refugees, and Ugandan citizens to Rwanda, to wit, Lieutenant Joel Mutabazi, Jackson Karemera alias Ndiga, Sergeant Innocent Kalisa, General Edward Kale, have you heard and understood the statement and particulars of the offense? Do you agree or deny the charge? Plea of not guilty entered.
This unlawful the tension, because it's beyond the 48 hours. We all know that. However, my Lord, and members of the tribunal, on his instruction, his own instruction and volition, and after intense consultation with his legal team, we acceded to his wishes. He was prepared to endure the indignity and personal discomfort and suffering, and allow those responsible for his confinement, his accusers presumably, to have a run through their pile of falsehoods, because he knew very well that truth would eventually triumph, but it didn't seem to take so long. My Lord and members, we are grateful that today, at least we have formal charges, and he's been able to answer to these charges, and he and us assisting him are going to prepare our defenses. Would like to commend the UPDF authorities generally and the military police headquarters